You Ought to Know on KCBQ is sponsored by the Love Radio Network.
Buckle up and start your engines. This is You Ought to Know on Intelligent Talk 1170 KCBQ. And now, here's your hosts, Dave and Cody.
All right, folks. Hey, welcome back. This is the You Ought to Know show right here on KCBQ AM 1170. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And we're going to sit around here for about an hour talking hot rods, cars, and you name it. I want to thank the folks at Hot Rods and Custom Stuff for all their support. 2324 Auto Parkway in Escondido. HotRodCustomStuff.com. 760-745-1170 if you're looking to fix up a hot rod, rebuild one, buy one, parts, pieces, you name it. That is your one-stop shopping, Hot Rods and Custom Stuff. Also want to thank the good folks at Bumper Doc, BumperDoc.com. If you're looking for any and all scratches, dings, and dents removed from your car, this guys will do it for you with a great lifetime guarantee. That's 866-DR-BUMPER, 866-DR-BUMPER. Well, I tell you what, I did a couple of interviews this week, and one of them was with Jennifer Ball. She's the first female president of the Mile of Cars down in National City, and the Mile of Cars just celebrated 60 years.
Wow.
They were the first Mile of Car in the United States.
Yeah.
First time anybody ever done a mall mentality with the whole line of cars. So let's go ahead and we'll take a listen to Jennifer.
Hey, folks, you know, there was a big birthday party down in National City. You may not have been aware of it, but if you buy cars and you look for good deals, that's the place I recommend, the Mile of Cars, the first and only Mile of Cars in the whole wide world. Jennifer Ball on the line, president of the Mile of Cars. How you doing, kid?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
All right, so did you open all the presents yourself, or did you share?
I share.
Oh, you're so good. You know, tell us a little bit about the history of the Mile of Cars. I don't think people really truly understand the importance of what has been done down there.
Well, the Mile of Cars started about 60 years ago, and it started with five dealers. And, you know, those five dealers got together and realized that working together as a group would get them a lot farther than working individually. So they formed the Mile of Cars to be able to, you know, advertise and have more selection for the community to come down. And now it's grown to what it is of 21 brands selling over 21,000 cars a year. So it's really grown, and it's just a strong pillar in our investment in the community. You know, all of the dealers are locally owned and owned by families, and we give back to the community a lot, and it's just it's a great association.
Yeah, and you hit it right on the head. You guys give a ton back to the community. You don't say much about it. The media, yeah, doesn't really care. You know, they would rather see you have a bad car or have a kind of a recall. I mean, I don't understand. It makes no sense to me,
right.
And that's why I'm talking to you right now. Because when I hear when you guys do these things, you know, the public, I swear, every time I talk to the public, oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
I had no idea they were doing that. Not even mentioning, and I'm not going to put you on the spot, but can you imagine if you told the public what you guys spend a month just in taxes? See what I'm saying? See what I'm saying?
And that's why, you know, I think has made the mall so successful. They have a great partnership with the city.
Yep.
We're a big tax base for National City, but we're good stewards of that, you know, like we're talking about. And we work well with the city officials. You know, we get involved with local nonprofits in National City and San Diego County to make it mutually beneficial for us and the community where we live and work in.
Without a doubt. And by the way, congratulations being the first lady to be the Mile of Cars Board of Directors.
Thank you.
And I've heard lots of good things about what you do. And, you know, I mean, who says a woman can't do it? Come on.
Not me.
You won't even get me to say that. Are you kidding? I'm not dumb. I've been around long enough. But, you know, again, you know, I tell people, you know, because people do have a tendency to forget about the Mile of Cars.
Yes.
I mean, and that's justifiable. But if all of a sudden somebody goes, oh, yeah, nine times out of ten, they'll buy a car from the Mile of Cars. Nine times out of ten, from what I've seen.
Yeah, you know, and it's great. Pretty much every dealer on the mile could tell you stories of customers coming by their office, giving stories about how they bought their first car from the mile 40 years ago, how they're back and are buying their third, fifth, even 10th car. You know, parents buying their car from the mile and then bringing their kids back. And so to me, I feel that's the great story and history of the mile of cars.
Yeah. And you know, you're not just talking to some doorknob reporter. I was a service manager at Frank Lincoln Mercury Hyundai.
Mm-hmm.
Don't ask me why Hyundai, but
That's a tough job.
I think the good Lord was punishing me. But now
I've done it.
Yeah, I know. And then, of course, look at the car now. And then I was at Frank. I was at Lane Pearson's over at the Dodge store. Mm-hmm. So I got my roots in the mile of cars. And I tell you, folks, you know, great dealer body. And if a parts need, somebody needs a part, there was always, you know, camaraderie between the group. Yeah.
Now, oh, yeah.
Yeah. It's, I just think people need to really check it out. You guys did a really nice makeover, I don't know how many years ago. You know, you put the flags up on the mile and you got the checkered flags in the crosswalks. And I think that's something that, you know, is important for people. Because you can go for a nice, long, leisurely walk and look at how many dealers.
Well, we have got 21 brands of cars, so we've pretty much have anything that you could look for. Trucks, imports, yep. Domestics, yep. Hybrids. I mean, you're right. You can literally walk a whole mile, and actually if you go up one side and down the other, you've now walked 2 miles.
There you go.
Get a little exercise in, and, you know, look at a ton of cars all at once, and that's a really unique venue that, like you're saying, you really can't get too many other places.
Yeah. And I got to spread the love just a tad bit. I just finished emceeing the firefighter demo derby.
Oh, yeah. It's a great event.
Give Monahans a big round of applause. They're sitting right there at the tail end on the south side of the mile. Just a little wrecking yard, family owned, just mm-hmm. like the dealers. Giving back like nobody's business. I mean, and that's the same thing. That whole area is surrounded by, you know, different businesses that support the mile of cars. And I mean,
yes.
it's a one-stop shop. I can't think of that upholstery guy's name. I know him personally, and I'd be darned if I can think of his name, but you name it, it's all right there.
Right.
And I highly recommend. So you had your birthday party on the 17th.
60 years.
Yep. Is anything happening from then on, or is it just pretty much, you know, a year-round celebration just come down?
Well, it's definitely a year-round celebration. Right. Like you said, we had the birthday party, and we are currently in the middle of our anniversary sale. And then in October or November, I believe, we'll do our year-end sale as well. So we have a couple of good sales going on now and one towards the end of the year. So, you know, it's always a great time to buy at the mile.
I totally agree. All right. Hey, Jennifer, thank you very, very, very much for calling in. Look forward to
Absolutely.
Chatting with you. And I'm sure I'll see you at the auto show.
You know you will.
All right.
Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure. You have a great day.
You too.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I'll tell you. I think it's – we are rolling.
Yes, indeed. We're back in just enough time to say goodbye.
Now we're going to take a small break, and we come back more of the You Oughta Know Show right here on KCBQ AM 1170. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And you do need to take a run down to the Mile of Cars if you've never been there. It's pretty cool. All right. We will be back in a moment. Stay tuned.
Listen to her tacking up now. Listen to her whine. Come on and turn it on. Wind it up. Blow it out.
Intelligent Talk, 1170 KCBQ, San Diego.
And online at kcbq.com.
Hey, everybody. All right, folks. Hey, welcome back. You're listening to the You Oughta Know Show right here on KCBQ AM 1170. This segment's brought to you by San Diego Carburetor and Fuel Injection, 6622 University Avenue down there in San Diego. Give them a call, 619-265-2400. Or go to www.sdcarb.com for all your automotive needs. Hey, I got another interview. I'm going to go ahead and have Nick run. This is from Ford Motor Company, and it's all about the new Ford Fusion, if I'm not mistaken. Let's take a listen.
Hey, guess what, folks? Ford's got a new announcement. Well, it's not really a new announcement. We're going to talk a little bit about the Ford Edge, all new Ford Edge. We've got the Ford Edge marketing manager, John
Gonsalves
on the line. How are you doing, sir?
Good.
Must be pretty excited about the new Edge. I mean, that thing, when it hit the ground running, you know, it did quite well. And so I'm pretty excited to see what the 2015 has to offer.
As we are. This is an all-new product.
for us. We've actually put it on a brand new platform, so you're going to get much better driving dynamics, and the vehicle is also going to be sold on a global landscape, right? So it's going to be in Europe as well, in China and other markets. So we're very happy to have a more competitive product than it already is.
So, I mean, I thought you did a pretty good job with the Edge coming in. I mean, it solved the family problems. I mean, it made a lot of people super happy. Tell the folks, what will they expect to see when it hits the showroom?
So in the new one, we took what already made Edge a successful product and made it better, right? We're putting it onto a better performing platform. You're going to have a much better fit and finish. Exterior styling is updated and improved, and your driving dynamics are going to be much, much better.
Engine choices?
EcoBoost, we're going to continue to offer the 2-liter EcoBoost,
right.
And even that is improved now with a twin-scroll turbocharger, so you get the torque up front and early. We'll also have a brand-new EcoBoost engine, which is our 2.7-liter V6 engine, which will be completely new to the product.
Wow. Now,
and that's going to be in our sport, so you're going to have a very high-performing sport this time around.
Oh, man. Well, and you know, let's face it. I mean, that's what you have to do. I mean, every year you have to come out with a better mousetrap to get the, because nowadays it's so tough. People ask me all the time, you know, what's the worst car on the market? I said, the one you're driving. Because everybody's building. I mean, nobody builds junk. I mean, those days are long gone. And now it's about, you know, connectivity and choice and, you know,
right.
how does it fit?
Semi-automated technologies,
yeah.
Right? So we're going to be a leader in semi-automated technologies. We're going to have enhanced active park assist where it'll parallel as well as perpendicular park for you.
Wow.
It's going to have lane keeping systems, side park sensors, which are brand new. We're going to have one of our greatest newest features is the adaptive steering, which, you know, anybody who's been in a tight parking situation where you're trying to turn the wheel, you have to turn it multiple times to kind of get it into a tight spot.
Mm-hmm.
This will allow you to do one rotation and get a full, you know, almost a full 100 or 90 degree turn into that spot.
Wow.
So it's a great feature, and it also adds confidence while you're driving at higher speeds, right? So it reduces your steering effort at low speeds, and it adds confidence at higher speeds. Other new technologies that we're really excited to bring to market is the 180 degree camera with a washer, right? So you're going to have, you know, you're going to have a camera that peeks out in front of you, so you can see around corners, and not that you have that issue there in San Diego, but us people here in Michigan, we get a lot of debris here during the winter months, so a very nice feature to have that.
Are you kidding? I just found out you guys have something back there called tire and wheel insurance. I never heard of that before in my life. I was talking to a buddy of mine that lives back there. He goes, are you kidding, man? I've paid for my policy like 3 months into the deal. But, I mean, you know, we won't go into it any deeper than that. But the people that know what I'm talking about.
Right.
Hey, I just jumped up on the Internet and looked at the pictures and the styling. You know, not massive changes, but subtle massaging, really nice looking lines.
Right. I think what you're going to see is that, you know, the overall package of the Edge, it still looks like an Edge to most people. People still wanted their Edge to look like an Edge. They didn't want a huge departure from what we've already offered. So we really just wanted to take the current product, which is, you know, a leading product within the market, and just make it that much better.
Yeah. Well, and I want to compliment you on the grill, because I think that grill is probably one of the nicest. And you guys have kind of spread that, you know, a little bit throughout the Ford line, a little bit into the, you know, in different areas. I just like it. I think it fits. I like the aggressive wheel well treatment on it. You know, the headlights, you know, it's clean. I can see this turning into a SEMA car quicker than you can shake a stick. I mean, it's got really nice lines.
Well, that was the intent, was to take, like I said, the current product and make a modern interpretation of it, but
right.
Plus add all of the driving dynamics that we wanted to add to make it a better driving vehicle. It's always been a great driving vehicle. People who drive, who own Edges, are very enthusiastic about them. It's one of those products when you talk to people who own them, that, you know, one of the words that always comes out, it's very emotional. People will say, I love my vehicle, right? Yeah. And they can't quite place exactly why, but you know, that is a common theme, that they love their Edge, and, you know, that it gives them everything that they want. We have a lot of technologies. The people embrace the technologies. You know, there's a lot of debate on introducing new technologies into vehicles, but Edge has always been one of those vehicles where our customers embrace the technology.
Yeah. Well, I'm looking at the dash right now, and boy, talk about everything compact, well within reach. You got a couple of cup holders, some coin stuff, a little paper slot. Everything is right. I really like the center stack a lot. I like the shifter where it's at, and you've got little cubby holes all over the place for all our junk that we haul around. The Europeans must go crazy when they see this. I go, what are you guys doing?
Speaking of the Europeans, this will be sold in Europe as well, and it will be competing there against a lot of premium vehicles such as the M5 and the Audi Q5. So it's going to be a global product for us that will compete against all shapes and sizes of competitors, right? You know, you're going to have your premium and you're going to have your regular vehicles, and this gives you an offering on all fronts.
Yeah. Well, you know, you guys have always had that world car mentality. I mean, you guys did that a long time ago. You're always trying to build a car for the world, and you've stayed true to that mantra. And, you know, and how about size-wise? Because, you know, if we're going to go to Europe, then, you know, and we're not talking just Europe. You're talking China, Russia. You're talking a whole lot of places. Does this size cause a problem with the roads and the tightness over there?
Well, you know, as I mentioned, there's competitors in the size. I mean, in many cases in Europe, the competitors in that size are slightly larger than the Edge. So there's already a market for vehicles of this size. The size itself is considered a premium size. So anybody, especially within Europe, that's moving up to, you know, this style of a vehicle is going to be paying a premium all around.
Right.
Just for different reasons.
Sure,
right?
sure. Well, and, you know, and let's face it, you know, the Europeans do love American vehicles. I mean, they always have, you know, and we all kind of like the European vehicle, so it's kind of a trade-off. But I think this vehicle, what are we looking at? Let me change subject. What's the price point? Because I haven't seen any info on it. Can you speak of that yet?
Well, the price points will be competitive with today's prices.
Okay.
So
we
don't have we haven't announced pricing on it yet,
right.
But it'll be very similar entry points to what you see today. So you'll be able to get into an Edge for about the same as what you can get into one today.
Yeah. Have you launched this yet, press-wise?
We will be launching it on tomorrow, actually.
You forgot my name. No, I'm only kidding. I'll beat up on John Delmonico. He's going to get me on one of these Ford press events. Because, I mean, you guys are doing such a great job. And where are you building this car?
We're going to be building it in Oakville, Ontario. We're actually investing $700 million into that plant to retool it in order to build a world-class product, right? So, you know, we're adding all of these new robotics and a lot of neat things that are going into that plant in order to help the quality. Plus, that plant has recently been announced that they did win the JD Power initial quality survey for producing the Edge out of that plant. So it's you know, within its segment, the Edge is the number one initial quality vehicle that was just announced by JD Power.
Well, I can see the smile on your face, and we're talking on radio. I don't understand it, but I can see the smile on your face.
I'm excited. The Edge is an emotional product, and I'm emotional about bringing it to everybody. So
yeah, well, I'm just as emotional about vehicles as you are. I mean, because I tell you, there's nothing. I mean, they're the greatest. I mean, it's part of the greatest part of our history is transportation, and you know, Ford's light bulb is still on, it's still bright. You're not using that anymore. I think you should bring it back. I mean, you know, I thought it was a good ad campaign, you know, bring that light bulb back. Well, I tell you what, John, it's always a joy talking to you guys. And when will the 2015 Ford Edge hit the showrooms?
We expect it in the first quarter of 2015.
Okay.
So we haven't officially announced the timing, but that's the time frame that we're expecting it.
Well, if you do a little launch later on down the road, just put the kid's name on it, and I'll come out there and hook you. If you come to San Diego, I'll put you on local TV, because that's what I do whenever anybody comes here. And I know you don't like San Diego. You'd rather stay back there. But, you know, if you decide you get a, you know, get that urge, come on out. We'd love to see you.
I would love to visit San Diego, especially in the middle of winter.
Come on,
here
John.
In Michigan.
Come on, John. Let's hook this thing up. Not a problem. We'll do something. Buddy, thank you always.
Thank you.
And folks, Ford.com, go there. I already went and looked. You can see pictures of it. You can see interior. And if it doesn't get you excited, then you should walk. John, thank you very much, and you have
thank
a great
you.
Week.
You too. Bye-bye.
All right, folks. Hey, well, I tell you what, that's you might want to check that rascal out when it comes to a dealer near you. I was just talking to Ken, and we've got it. What's this event we're going to next week on the 9th?
It is BMW's introduction of what their police models, from the new police models.
And it's a Tuesday?
It's up in Orange.
Yeah,
I think it's July 9th.
July 9th, yeah. Mm-hmm. So we may have to take a run up to San Diego BMW Motorcycle, get a couple of bikes, and take them a ride, take those up there instead of taking a cage.
All I can say is, wow.
Yeah. Well, like I said, I'm not driving in them little Beamers. I want a big Beamer motorcycle. I'll wear my shirt that says, you know, what does it say? Something like, I just passed a BMW and I didn't know they made cars.
Oh,
it's for the motorcycle shirt. Hey, we're going to take a small break and we come back more right here on the You Ought to Know Show. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And this is KCBQ AM 1170 Intelligent Talk Radio.
I woke up this afternoon and looked into your eyes, and something was as wrong as if the sun forgot to rise. I picked up a road map and I checked a few good places that I know.
And if you're no longer... Intelligent Talk, 1170 KCBQ.
Folks, hey, welcome back. You're listening to the You Ought to Know Show. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And this segment's brought to you by San Diego RV Center. Give them a call, 619-561-3531. If you have an RV that needs tender, loving care, trust me, this is where I recommend you go. San Diego RV Center. Go to sandiegorvcenter.com for more information. They're located at 9398 Bond Avenue in El Cajon. If you have an RV that's getting up in age and your roof is starting to get questionable, and trust me, if you haven't crawled up there to look at it, it'd be worth you doing that. They have a process. It's like rhino lining, but they do it on your roof, and you get a lifetime guarantee. You pay for it one time, and you're done. San Diego RV Center, they do everything in-house, so they have total control over the end product. Give it a look. Hey, this is the last weekend of the Del Mar Fair, and I said last weekend that I was done giving out tickets, but I was told that I could do it again. So let's take a listen to Linda Zweig, and she'll fill you in on what you're missing if you haven't been to the fair.
All right. I don't know about you folks, but the fair is coming. I'm so excited. I can't stand it. Oh, my gosh. I got my good friend Linda on the line. Linda Zweig, how you doing, girl?
I'm doing well, going a little crazy. So crazy, my hair is curling. The fair is just about here. We open on Saturday, June 7th, and things are so busy here at the fairgrounds, I can't even tell you.
Jeez. Hey, what's the theme this year?
The Fab Fair! Boy, it's all over the place now. We're celebrating the 50th anniversary of the British music invasion.
No.
50 years ago, the Beatles set foot on Ed Sullivan's stage, and then the rest is history.
Wow. All right. Well, with that being said, I'm sure you're going to have some kind of bands that play that style of music.
Oh, gosh. Well, first of all, every day of the fair, there's going to be Beatles music around the... We have 8 stages.
Mm-hmm.
And what's really cool this year is when you come in the fair, into the fairgrounds, or into the fair, on the fairgrounds, rather, through the main gate, the first building to your right is our theme exhibit. Every year, of course, we have a new theme, which is why we're the fourth largest fair in North America, and we're always breaking records. Well,
wow.
This year, it's extra specially special because we're going to be focusing on the British invasion and the Beatles, and we're going to have never-before-seen photographs of the Beatles, some from the Life magazine photographer from the 60s, and also some never-before-seen in California photos of John and Yoko's Bed In for Peace. Do you remember that? Oh, some of us are old enough to remember
that. Yeah, I do remember that.
Yeah, yeah. And so it's going to be very interesting. And also, as usual, interactive. We're going to have some photograph opportunities like Abbey Road and some others. And, you know, there's always an educational part of the exhibit as well, along with interaction, because there's a lot of history there. And for you music buffs and even the younger demographic, the younger kids are familiar with the Beatles because everything sort of has come full circle.
Yeah.
And it's just absolutely amazing.
Wow. All right. Well, that in itself was enough. I mean, that in itself will keep everybody occupied and busy, but there's a whole lot more.
That's just the tip of the iceberg. First of all, let me say, we open on Saturday, June 7th, and run through Sunday, July 6th.
Okay.
We're closed every Monday and the first two Tuesdays. So we have 5 weekends.
Wow.
We have 8 stages. And you can't come once to the fair and see it all. And I just need to get a little plug for the best pass ever. The best pass ever is the best deal out there. You can come to the fair every day for $1 a day.
Really?
$24, yep, get you into the fair every single solitary day. So if you want to come one day just to come in the morning, have a cup of coffee and your cinnamon rolls and go watch the cows being milked and then come later on or the next day for a concert, that's your ticket to the fair. Get you in, and you can get them at your friendly neighborhood Albertson Savon store or here online at sdfair.com, actually on your computer.
Right.
Speaking of which, we have the Toyota Summer Concert Series on the Heineken Grandstand stage every night of the fair. We have Third Eye Blind, Jeff Dunham, Darius Rucker. By the way, I'm getting more phone calls about Darius Rucker. He used to be with Hootie and the Blowfish. What a voice.
Yeah.
Smokey Robinson, Zendaya, the Fab Four.
Wow.
That's the Beatles. That's the Beatles cover band. Digitour, Matis Yahoo. We have the 10th Annual Gospel Festival featuring Fred Hammond with Brent Jones. We have Toni Braxton and Kenny Babyface Edmonds, Huey Lewis and the News, Mario Speedwagon, Hunter Hayes. And that's just the tip of the iceberg there. And in fact, on the 4th of July, we have free with your fair admission, the Navy Band Southwest with the biggest fireworks display, and America on the 4th of July. So all that information, of course, is at sdfair.com.
Well, I got to tell folks a little story. I go to the fair all the time. I go 2 or 3 times because that's just the kind of guy I am. And one thing the fair does, a lot of people may not be aware of, you book bands and singers, and all of a sudden they're here at the fair. Next thing you know, Tim McGraw. I remember watching Tim McGraw for free in the grandstands when he was on the stage. It was just free, just some little country western guy. Look where he's at today. So
look at Bruno Mars.
Yeah, Bruno Mars.
A couple of years ago,
yeah,
he was on the cusp. Just on the cusp, and it was a sellout. It was a blowout.
I know.
And but speaking of which, you know, like I said, we have several stages, and a handful of the grandstand stage performers requires a ticket. Otherwise, they're all free.
Right.
There are always reserved seats available and dinner packages as well. But we have the Paddock Concert Series as well. We have Taylor Hicks, who was on our grandstand stage a couple of years ago. We have the McCartney Years, Teen Hoot, Who's Bad, Leon Russell.
Jeez.
Leon Russell.
Wow.
Cooper Diamond, Grand Funk Railroad, and more. And then my personal favorite is always the Solid Gold Series. This year, we have on June 12th, Gary Puckett and the Union Gap.
Wow.
On the 19th, Johnny Rivers.
Really?
Spinners on the 26th, and Moondoggy on July 3rd. James Darren is coming out to sing on July 3rd.
No kidding.
Yeah, no kidding.
It's you must.
And, of course, we have the Coors Rock on stage, too. Oh, one thing I want to let everybody know
that
all day long we have walk-around entertainment as well. But here's the thing. You can go to the grandstand show at 7:30, then sneak over to the paddock to see the 9 o'clock show in the paddock series. And then there's also a 9 o'clock show at the Coors Rock-On series, the Coors Light Rock-On series near the carnival. The Solid Gold series, of course, is on Thursdays at 1 o'clock. So there's always something going on.
Yeah.
Always music to see.
Plus the carnival. I mean, let's not forget the carnival. That thing is massive.
It is massive. Our big carnival is massive. We have some new thrill rides this year that are very exciting. Another thing that's very exciting is the infield has been redesigned and renamed. It's called Family Funville. Mm. And there is a carnival in the infield as well. That's for the younger kids.
Right.
But what's so cool about the infield this year, of course, we have the zip line. We have the farm. The family farm has been entirely redesigned. Everything is organic and growing out there. And in fact, a little secret I always tell everybody, my cohort, partner in crime, Elaine and myself, sneak out there a couple times a week, and they call us Peter Rabbit because we go out there and steal the vegetables that are growing. They're absolutely beautiful, and it's just a beautiful display. There's going to be a butterfly display out there and ladybugs, and it's very educational and interactive out there as well. There's a beehive that shows folks how the bees make honey, and a corn shucking contest and watermelon seed spitting contest. And that's just out there in the wonderful world of horses. And, of course, there is a stage out there where a lot of our local bands and dance companies, dance studios go out there, and the kids have concerts or little dancing shows. And, of course, we have Godfrey the Magician out there, and we have wonderful bird shows out there. And Giovanna's out there. She used to be Dogs with the Wild West, but now she does a special show that's also a lot of fun. And there's just a lot going on out there. And we haven't even talked about the livestock.
No.
Because every day of the fair, there's livestock in our agri-fair and in our barns. And, of course, it culminates at the end of the beginning of July with the junior livestock auction. We have the 4-H kids, the FFA kids, and Grange kids out here. And Dave, we haven't even talked food yet.
No, we haven't. Well, we're saving that for last. Otherwise, when we're done, we won't be able to walk.
No, of course not. Well, you know what? You can walk everything off because the fair's so big.
That's right.
You can just eat to your heart's content and walk it off. And, of course, we have the flower show and the garden show. Mm-hmm. And this year, the theme is Flower Power. And let's not forget the International Beer Festival and our Toast of the Coast Wine Festival.
Wow.
And, of course, our Big Bite Bacon Fest. And all of the information for dates, times, and ticket information is at sgfair.com. The International Beer Fest is one of the top 10 beer festivals in the United States. And it's a 3-day event in the middle of June, and Toast of the Coast is a 2-day event. And this year we are featuring wines all throughout California and the Baja experience as well. We're going to have wines for the first time from the Guadalupe Valley and some food. And it's going to be a whole lot of fun. And, of course, the Big Bite Bacon Fest takes place the last weekend, and we're going to have a bacon wedding again.
Really? Another one? That is so cool. I love it. Hey, and you forgot one thing. Oh, my gosh. What's opening day? What is going to be coming in opening day in the arena to the east? That dirt arena underside? The Firefighter Demo Derby.
Oh, yeah, the San Diego Burn Institute.
Woo!
They're going to be there with the firefighters. And by the way, opening day, which is on Friday, June 7th, you can come in for $4.
Really?
If you go to your friendly neighborhood Albertsons Save-On store with a minimum $10 purchase, you can buy a $4 ticket to get in. There's no reason anybody needs to pay full price to get into the San Diego Fair with all the deals that are out there, including the Fair Tripper. And you take the coaster, $15 gets you a round-trip ticket on the coaster and entrance to the fair.
Wow, that's killer. No parking
and, really
and a great
cool.
view.
And a great view. You know what? That and NCTD, North County Transit District, with the bus, if you bring your same-day ticket, you get $3.50 off general admission to get in here. With all of the wonderful food and drink and our wine festivals and beer festivals, tequila festivals, I say let our public transportation system be your designated property for San Diego County Fair. You don't have to deal with driving, parking, traffic, and you can just party on the way here, party here, and party on the way home.
So smart. I'm here to tell you. And then, of course, you've got the buildings full of every gadget. I bought more of those little salsa makers. I always stand next to the guy, and I help him sell them because they're the greatest thing in the world. And I always go I get new blades. He'll sell you the blades individually.
What's so wonderful?
What's that?
Here's the thing, Dave, is that you're right. We get the greatest concessionaires and vendors inside our buildings and the greatest products. And every year we have new products, but some of the standards like Vitamix and the salsa makers like you're talking, they come back year after year after year. And these vendors, these partners that we have are vetted every year.
Yeah.
So people can come to the San Diego County Fair and make their purchases knowing that these are our partners and they can get a hold of these folks all year if they need to replace something. Or everything is, they stand behind all of their products, of course. And they can come back and see what's handy-dandy and new the following year.
I know. All right, let's give the website out one more time.
The website is www.skifair.com. Go to skifair.com and check that website every day because it's constantly being updated. You can find out about all the deals, all the, you know, one pay one price wristband days for the carnivals, and all the wonderful food that we're going to have this year.
Wow.
I mean, it's constantly updated. All your information is there. And again, the best deal in town is the best pass ever, 24 days for $24.
Absolutely. And, folks, when we get done with this interview, I'm going to open up the line. We're going to see, give away a few tickets. She was nice.
Absolutely.
Linda was nice enough to hook. See, there's a million ways to go to the fair, so there's no excuse. None whatsoever.
None.
All right, kiddo. Hey, I hear your shoes are cooling down. I think you need to get back at it.
Okay,
I see the smoke. I see the smoke.
You see the smoke? You see it coming through the airwaves. Okay, hey, Dave, I want to see you tomorrow. We're having a special media event for
our will...
media partners and friends, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Can't wait.
Okay.
All right, kiddo.
All right.
Take care.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
All right, folks, this is it. If you want to go to the fair to next week, stalld@cox.net, S-T-A-L-L-D at cox.net. Send me a request. You can have as many as up to 6 tickets per person. I need first name, last name, and how many tickets, and they will go into will call. So all you'll have to do is bring a, you know, picture ID, pick them up at the will call door right next to the general admission ticket booth at the front of the fair. So if you're interested, send me an email as we speak, stalld@cox.net. Right now we're going to take a small break. We come back, I'm going to tell you all about Detroit. Yep, back there with Chrysler, actually Dodge, celebrating their 100th anniversary. Take a listen when we come back. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And this is KCBQ.
Got those Pro-Stock blues. It's the same old news.
Keep up with KCBQ hosts and current events. Like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. Look for the icons online at kcbq.com.
Guess you better slow your Mustang. All right, folks, hey, welcome back. You're listening to the You Oughta Know Show. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And this segment is brought to you by the folks at Midnight Oil Motors, 9040 Carroll Way in San Diego, 858-271-9944. Go to Midnight Oil Motors. If you have a British, Japanese, Italian, American, it don't make any difference. These guys can work on it all. They'll even race prep your car, if you can believe that. Hey, another great, great advertiser, Cottonwood Golf Service. Cottonwood Electric Cart Service. They're located over there on 880 El Cajon Boulevard. Right now they're up on Hill Street, but if you go to their website, cottonwoodelectric.com, you can find out the information. But these guys really do some phenomenal work. They did a complete redo on my old Yamaha golf cart. Excellent. And I tell you, these guys are great. Looking for new, used, service, rental, you name it, they've got it. 619-440-2127. Make sure you tell them that the gang at KCBQ sent you. Well, I was in... was in Detroit last week, sir. Went back for the 2015 lineup.
It's lucky.
Kind of a meet and greet. They do it every year. But this time it was rather unique, only because Dodge celebrated a 100-year anniversary as of 2014 with their first vehicle was a 1914 Dodge. First all-steel body car. See, Henry didn't do steel. He didn't do all... You know, because he was trying to save money. I think the Dodge was like $300 more than the Jeez. Model T. $700 versus $400.
Right.
So Chrysler or Dodge, you know, they were trying to decide what could we do, you know, to really celebrate. Yeah, we can have a cake. You know, we can write a book,
which they did.
You know, we can. You know, but then what they decided to do, because they really wanted to get the word out, is they went in, we went to the Dodge Brothers' home, where the first 1915 Dodge was built in a barn, right on premises. And this place is gorgeous. I think I sent pictures on Facebook. And so, you know, walking through the place, I mean, it's just so majestic, I can't even begin to tell you. And what's really interesting, a lot of people are not aware of, that the Dodge Brothers originally were part suppliers to Ford and some of the other manufacturers. They were making parts, pieces, widgets, and what right. have you, and selling them. And their biggest contract was Ford Motor Company.
Huh.
And the brothers just decided one year, you know, let's see if we can do our own. So they severed their relationship with Ford and started building their own cars. Well, I think they started, well, they started in 1915. And by 1921, both brothers died from different ailments. And so they only really worked on this this thing for 5 years, but it was taken over. I mean, the family sold it to Chrysler, and then, you know, and the rest is history. But even the guys at Chrysler right or Dodge right now will tell you that that mindset that the brothers had is still there. They are very, you know, they were very performance oriented. They were always out of the box, and that's kind of where Dodge is going.
Right.
They, you know, they're coming out with a complete new line. So consequently, to celebrate this 100-year anniversary, they went into the private museum that the Dodge family still owns. It's not open to the general public. You can't go walk through it and kick tires. So they brought out close to 20. Well, I have a list right here. I mean, I can go through it, but I'm not going to go through the whole thing. But, you know, there were everything from a 1915 Dodge Brother Touring, 1919, 1920, 27, 39, and it just goes on and on and on. And it gave us journalists an opportunity to ride and to go drive these vehicles. We didn't get to drive the 1915 because it was so rare.
Right.
And those are a little temperamental to drive, but we did get to drive almost everything else, even a military little vehicle, which was, if you like old cars and then driving these things, I mean, it's like, really? Steering wheels are so big, I can't even begin to tell you. And so skinny.
Yeah.
Skinny, but massive steering wheels.
Right. No power steering.
Yeah, but the one they do have power steering, oh my gosh, does it have power steering? It's like butter. It'll just spin like crazy. But, and it was just a great way to kind of look at Dodge's 100-year. And, you know, they didn't sugarcoat it. They brought out a Dodge Neon. They brought out an Intrepid. You know, they brought out a minivan. And, you know, these were good cars. They weren't, except for the minivan, but they had their mechanical issues.
Right.
But, you know, they didn't just, like I said, they just didn't bring the fun stuff out. They did bring out a Dodge Super B with the wing.
Yep.
And I didn't get into it deep enough, but this was a non-vinyl roof car. And a non-vinyl roof Super B usually meant it was destined for NASCAR.
Right. You know, it was one of the ones that they had to build in order to qualify
correct.
To they race.
They had to build X amount right. to, they have that big word, omologato or whatever it is. I mean, they have to build a certain amount of them to be able to race them.
Right.
Which they did, and it was so funny, it was nobody would buy them. They're really ugly. I mean, if you really look at a Super B, I mean, it's with that honking nose on the front and the big wing in the back. I mean, it's what it was supposed to do, and that's win races, but man, was that thing ugly. But I got a chance to drive that. Then I got to drive a Super B, and then I got to drive. I mean, you get out of one, you get into another. You get out of one, you get in. And it was so funny because probably 60% of the cars didn't have seatbelts.
Of course,
And you see all these journalists in there looking around and reaching and grabbing and trying to find seatbelts. The one car that it was the first car that I went to start, and it's a 1956 Dodge. I think it was a Coronet.
And
it was painted up as a NASCAR. It was a replica, but it had the big Hemi engine in it and push button. And that stupid push button was just like the push button today. You could push and push and push. And then finally the guys had to come over. We finally got that working. Then I couldn't get it started. It flooded it. So they had to pop the air cleaner. Everybody else is out gone in cars, and I'm still sitting there. So I ain't leaving this thing. So this was just finally. And off I went, you know. So I had a good time with that. And it was so funny because I had taken the Neon out, and I come whipping around with a Neon. And the guy thought I was just somebody who tried to get me to go pull into the parking space just to park the car. I go, no, this is part of the museum. And he didn't believe me, but it was quite an event, mainly because you know when these manufacturers are starting to celebrate their birthdays. I mean, they're all looking for different ways, like Scat Pack. You know, there's a that was a accessory pack that they had back in the day, and they brought it back with the new Challenger. Shaker hoods, you know, they brought that back. You know, in fact, they're really digging into their nostalgic toolbox and coming out with now, in what, 2 or 3 weeks, I'm going back to Oregon, to Portland International Raceway, to drive the 600 horsepower Challenger.
Wow.
Yeah, that's what I said. Whoa, 600 horse in a Challenger on a racetrack? Yeah. So, but, you know, I got to say, Chrysler has really, and Dodge has really done their homework. In fact, in the next hour, we've got Cody Raiders calling in at the top of the hour. We're going to talk about his exciting day up at Glen Helen, I think he was at. Or Lake Elsinore, I'm not quite sure which. We'll get the information from him. And then I've got a couple of interviews. The quality is not the greatest, but that's just the way it was at the time. I was doing some interviewing at the track, at the autocross track, and I interviewed the main guy for the Alfa Romeo 4CV, the 4C, which is our new little two-seat sports car, mid-engine. Man, that thing is, I mean, it kind of looks like a Lotus, you know, a little right. Lotus right. Evora.
Right.
Slash Tesla slash, you know. Yeah. But man, handle, get up and go, corner. I'm not a paddle shifter, but I really liked the whole feel of that car. There wasn't anything about it I didn't like, actually. Didn't have to wear a helmet, so that was kind of nice. It was comfy.
Well, you know, I went up to the... Thank you for allowing me to, but I went to the Chrysler 200 rollout in L.A., and one thing I drug away from that was Chrysler ain't laying down.
Oh, no.
And they've come to play in the automotive.
Oh, yeah. Well, Marchione's not going to let it happen, right? Folks. These Alphas coming across the pond, you're going to love them. Hey, we're going to hit the dusty trail, but want to hang around. SD Motorsports. We'll talk about the Alpha on the Motorsports Show right here on KCBQ AM 1170. I'm Dave.
And I'm Ken.
And we will be back. Yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving place. Buy all of the guns and bombs and explode into space. I like smoking lightning. Heavy metal thunder. Racing with the wind and the feeling that I'm under. Yeah, I gotta go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. You Ought to Know on KCBQ is sponsored by the Love Radio Network.